Well, glycerin really doesn't want to mix in. You just sort of see the blob.
Hey guys, I'm Nate. Welcome back to the workshop where once again, we're gonna be doing some fun experiments with glow sticks. Last time playing around with the glow sticks and the fluid inside, we discovered some fun properties of them, like how to make them glow brighter by heating them up or oddly by mixing them with dish soap. Today we have a variety of experiments we wanna try. We're gonna see what happens if we mix a bunch of different fluids with our glow sticks and see if they react at all. We'll try taking our glow sticks and popping them in the microwave to see what happens if we heat them up like that. And then we'll take a bunch of our glow stick fluid and we'll put it in the vacuum chamber to see if we can get some glowing bubbles, because I think that would look really cool. We've got a bunch of glow sticks and we've got a bunch of stuff to mix into them. Let's get started. I've got a whole lot of glow sticks cracked open into some cups. They aren't really activated yet because we haven't cracked open the colored portion in the glass vials, but we'll do that one at a time and then try adding our chemicals and see what sort of reactions we get. There we go, very nice, bright liquid. This is actually a mix of three different colors. We've got like the green and the yellow and the orange, I think, all mixed together. Really interesting how it can look orange and green at the same time. Look at it there, it looks green, turned a little bit. There's more orange look to it. It's really interesting. Now, as a reminder for why we're trying all of these chemicals, here's what happens if we mix a little bit of dish soap in with our glow fluid. It suddenly gets way, way brighter. Like it was already very bright. Then you mix that soap in, and it just gets crazy like a lantern. But putting out all that energy has a cost. It no longer lasts nearly as long. Once the soap is mixed in, it gets very bright, but then it starts to dim after not too much time. We also discovered that if we go ahead and add more soap after it's already started reacting and slowing down, all of that light just gets sucked right out of it. We're back down to barely glow. It's not even glowing anymore. Craziness. So, that was discovered completely by accident. Let's see if we get any other sorts of kind of similar results from any of these variety of chemicals. Most of these are just picked at random because I thought they all might have different compositions and I wanted to see if they would do anything. That looks like a cup full of lava. For this one, we're gonna see what happens if we mix in some household bleach. It's actually reacting, like something is bubbling and fizzing in there. I don't know if it looks like the color is changing. I don't think it's really getting any brighter, but it is reacting. Let's see what's next. That's an interesting color right there. This one has four of the magenta sort of colored and one of the orange. And it's giving us this sort of peach colored glow. Pretty fun. For this one, we are going to see what happens if we mix in some super glue. Here it goes. Well, the color changed and I think it got dimmer. Let's add a little bit more. Oh yeah. That just got way darker. Something about the super glue is stopping the chemical reaction that puts off light. That's interesting. It also seems to be doing a really good job of actually mixing in. Like there's not clumps of super glue floating around or bits of it stuck to the bottom. It seems like it's just dissolved into the liquid. In the first video, I talked about how the glow stick fluid has a very oily texture on my fingers. We'll see what happens if we just mix in a little bit of 3-in-1 oil. I think that's getting dimmer. We are losing light. Definitely less bright than it was a second ago. Let's try adding more. Much dimmer. Pulls it way down. Almost as much as the super glue, I think. There's still a little bit of glow to it. Not very much. Well, we got some cool reactions with the bleach, the super glue, and the 3-in-1 oil. We didn't get any change with the others. We tried dish detergent, isopropyl alcohol, glycerin, hydrogen peroxide, clear Elmer's glue, and methyl alcohol, but we didn't see any noticeable results. With our experiments done of mixing the different chemicals into our glow fluid, it's time to move on to our next test, which is going to be microwaving our glow sticks. I've got three identical glow sticks and we'll prep them all differently to compare the three. One of them I'll crack and leave out of the microwave, one of them I'll crack and put into the microwave, and the other one I'll put into the microwave first, and then I'll crack it, and we'll see what difference in glowing brightness we get out of them. Oh yeah, that's definitely getting brighter. All right, that was about 10 seconds. You know, it's not very warm though, and I think it is supposed to be the heat that activates it, so I'm actually just gonna put it in for a little bit longer. Hopefully it doesn't explode in the microwave. All right, that's noticeably warm now in my hand. And we can already see the difference between the microwaved one and the not microwaved one. It definitely is brighter. So now let's try cracking the microwaved one that hasn't been cracked yet and see if it's the same brightness as the one that we cracked first and then microwaved. I bet it will be. Ooh, and it went very quickly. That activated much faster. Might even be a little bit brighter. Maybe that's just because it's been cracked for only a couple seconds and the initial chemical reaction is brighter. We can see that the warm ones are definitely brighter than the cool one. And it does seem like the one that I microwaved first and then cracked is brighter than the one I cracked and then microwaved. Let's also try taking one of our cups that didn't really seem to react with the chemicals in it and put that in the microwave and see if it gets brighter. This is the cup that had the isopropyl alcohol mixed in and it didn't really change much. So let's see if a couple seconds in the microwave heats it up. Oh yeah, absolutely heats it up and makes it much brighter. Oh, and I started boiling it even. That's isopropyl alcohol for you. It doesn't take a lot of heat. Oh, and it's dripping, so I may have maybe melted through part of the cup or something like that. I think the structural integrity of my cup is compromised. That is way brighter. Comparison next to the hydrogen peroxide, which also didn't change it much. Heat definitely adds something. We've learned what happens when we mix a bunch of chemicals in with our glow fluid, and we've experimented with using our glow sticks in the microwave to pretty great effect. It got quite a bit brighter. Now I think what we need to do is take a bunch of our glow stick fluid, put it in a cup, and see what happens to it in a vacuum chamber. Before I activate our glow fluid and put it in the vacuum chamber, I do want the best glow possible, so I am gonna throw it in the microwave for about 10 seconds. I'm not gonna add the soap though, because I think that might change how it bubbles, and I'm afraid that it would be really bright but then die out too quickly. So we'll have it warm, but no chemicals added to it. All right, pressure is dropping in the container. I see some bubbles starting to form. There we go, that is bubbling. It's about the coolest thing I've ever seen boiling. Now that I've seen what happens without any soap mixed into it, I feel like I kind of have to try with the dish soap mixed in because it does make it so much brighter. Let's give it a shot. Whoa, all of the brightness is going away. Not all of it, but a lot of it. Oh, and we get big old bubbles from the soap. That does look like some weirdo magical potion right there. But most of that glow is gone. It's interesting, it just looks like there's a little bit of glowy on the very bottom, but that everything else has sort of stopped glowing. Add back some pressure. This is pretty wild. Yeah, we've just got a little bit of glowing on the very bottom of the cup. It's almost pink,
too. There was one pink glow stick and four blue glow sticks. Look from the top down, you can also see that it's just separated around to this ring at the bottom. So something about the soap and the vacuum really made it separate apart. Maybe that's just the pure fluorescent dye or something, I'm not sure. Let's see if the cup still glows under a black light. It does, but not nearly as much. Here's the pink color that we mixed one of our other chemicals into, and it still has a fair amount of glow. You can see just how dim this one is at this point. This glow fluid is a lot of fun to play with, and we've got some fun ideas of what to do with it, but if you have any others, let us know down in the comments. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you're not a subscriber yet, just hit the bomb to get in the club. If you missed our last video or want to watch it again, click up here at the top. Click down there if you want to see what the internet thinks that you should watch next. That's it for now. Have fun, be safe, and see you tomorrow.